Hello students, welcome to our channel SRIP Edu Pharma. We are going to start today's video on analytical cosmetics, BIS specifications for shampoos, toothpastes and skin creams. This is a topic of the subject cosmetic science of BPharm 8th semester new PCI syllabus. First of all, we will understand what BIS is, its full form and its background. So BIS is Bureau of Indian Standards. It is the National Standards Body of India and it functions under the Ministry of Consumer Affairs. And basically, it is concerned with standardization, certification and quality. So we can see here, this is the logo of BIS, which is also called in Hindi as Bharatiya Manak Bureau. If we see the background or history, then in 1947 there was Indian Standards Institution, that is ISI, which was constituted. Then later on in 1986, the Bureau of Indian Standards Act came, and then on 1st April 1987, the Bureau of Indian Standards was implemented. So this is the background of BIS. So now we will see what were the main objectives of BIS specifications. So the important or main objective behind BIS specification was the harmonious development of various activities related to standardization, marking and quality certification. And especially it provides new thrust to standardization and quality control. So here we can say that it is the national strategy according to which the standards are recognized and there is integration between all the parameters and there is growth and development of industrial production and exports. So basically the product specification, method of test, code of practices, terminologies, basic standards, all these are present in BIS specifications. So when we see the main activities of BIS specifications, then it constitutes the standards of the formulations, then various types of certifications related to product, then hallmarking of gold jewelry, quality management system, then environmental management systems, occupational health and safety management system, then hazard analysis and critical control points, imported products, FMCS. All these are constituted in the BIS specifications. Then other ones are laboratory management, international activities, training services and other specifications or other activities include information services, consumer affairs and standards, promotion and sale of standards. So these are the important or these are the summary of the various type of activities related to BIS specifications. So when we see the Indian standards on cosmetics then, 30 Indian standards on finished cosmetics are listed in Schedule S of the Drug and Cosmetics Act 1940 and Rules 1945, as per which the cosmetics in their finished form are manufactured or imported and they need to conform to these specifications. So here we have to remember that the Indian standards on cosmetics are present in Schedule S. Here we have listed the 30 important or the 30 finished products or cosmetics which are included in Schedule S of the Drug and Cosmetic Rules 1945. These are skin powders for infants, tooth powder, toothpaste, skin creams, hair oil, shampoos, soap based and synthetic detergent based and hair creams, oxidation hair dyes, liquid, cologne, nail polish, after shave lotion, pomades and brilliantines, depilatories, chemicals, shaving creams, cosmetic pencils, lipsticks, lip salts, then powder hair dyes, bindi liquid, kumkum powder, henna powder, sindoor, liquid foundation makeup, cold wax hair remover, face pack, kajal, oxidation hair dyes and cream bleach. So here you can see that in the bracket there is given various specifications. So these are the specifications which are included related to these finished products. We know that shampoos are especially used for cleaning our hair and there are various types of BIS requirements related to these shampoos, and various tests are given. But here we have summarized in very short way that if the BIS requirements of shampoos is asked, then what you have to write. So first of all, the pH of the shampoo should be between 4 to 9. Then the maximum heavy metal, that is lead, is permitted in shampoos is 20 parts per million, that is 20 ppm. Then the maximum arsenic, that is As2O3, permitted in shampoos is 2 ppm. Then here one more important thing is list of dyes, colors and pigments permitted to be used in cosmetics is under Schedule Q of Drug and Cosmetics Act. Here heavy metal, that is lead 20 ppm and arsenic 2 ppm. This is common for all the type of formulations when we will be seeing. Then here comes the non-volatile alcohol soluble matter percent by mass. This minimum quantity is 10%. Then foam height for 2% solution, the minimum should be 150 mm. Here we have to remember that where it is given maximum and where it is given minimum, that you have to remember. And the dyes, colors and pigments, they all come under Schedule Q of Drug and Cosmetic Act. This also you have to remember. Now we will be seeing toothpaste. These are the dentifrices which are used for cleaning our teeth, and the toothpaste are of two categories. One is fluoride containing and another is non-fluoride containing. So according to that, requirements are a bit different. First we will see the fineness of the particles. So particles retained on 150 micron ISC percent by mass, this maximum should be 10 for non-fluoridated and 1 for fluoridated. Then second point, the particles retained on 75 micron ISC percent by mass, maximum should be 2.5 for non-fluoridated and same 2.5 for fluoridated. Then comes the pH of aqueous suspension should be 5.5 to 10.5. This is for these both. You have to remember that initially in the case of shampoos, we saw 4 to 9, but here in the case of toothpaste, we are seeing 5.5 to 10.5. As we had previously seen that maximum heavy metal lead permitted was 20 ppm, same is here also, and maximum quantity of arsenic permitted is 2 ppm. Then foaming power ml, minimum should be 50 for both the type of toothpaste. Then available fluoride ion ppm quantity, maximum is 50 for non-fluoridated, and for fluoridated it should be 1000. Then we will be seeing microbial count. So total viable counts per gram maximum should be 1000 for both the cases, but the gram negative pathogens per gram should be absent. Now we'll be seeing the BIS requirements of skin creams. Skin creams include all the type of cold cream, vanishing cream and different types of sunscreen creams or the creams that we are applying on the skin. Here thermal stability should be, it should pass the test of that stability. Then in the case of pH, it should be between 4 to 9. But for the creams which have beeswax and borax, the pH should be between 5 to 10. So this is the point that you have to remember. Then the case of lead is same, 20 ppm. The maximum quantity of arsenic is 2 ppm. This is also same. The list of dyes, colors and pigments permitted are in Schedule Q of Drug and Cosmetics Act. This we have already seen. Then total fatty substance content percent by mass, minimum quantity is 5. Then total residue percent by mass, minimum quantity is 10. Then microbial count, total viable counts per gram, maximum is 1000, and gram negative pathogens per gram should be absent. So these are the important requirements related to skin creams. So dear students, here we come to the end of our video. We have tried to summarize the BIS specifications in very simple way, so that if any short note comes, you can easily write it. So keep learning, stay connected with us. If you have not yet subscribed our YouTube channel SRIP Edu Pharma, then do subscribe the channel and do like, share and give comments what you are feeling or what you want to give us more suggestions. So we will be waiting for your comments. Stay connected with us. Keep watching the videos. Thank you so much.